It's the turn of Converse to host a World Cup Grand Prix event, the seventh in the current series. Once again, some of the sport's greatest names are competing for honours, and over 80 gymnasts from 27 countries have contested the 10 apparatus events across 3 days of competition. You join us at the final stages. 8 gymnasts have progressed from the qualifying rounds and ready to do battle for the major honours. On come the finalists for the first 2 events. And what's unique about this competition is that the final takes place, but it's not over then. The best 2 competitors from that final have to go head to head to settle matters for first and second places. So we're treated to start with the men's floor final. There's Alexei Nemov there, Yevgeny Podgorny, both from Russia, the great Ivan Ivankov, twice world champion. Soleny, the ring specialist. Zoltan Supula, 30 years old now, a bit of a veteran. Victoria Karpenko, the great Simona Aminar. And there, towering above the rest, Svetlana Kukina, who hasn't been beaten in a major bars event since 1994. So, we have a men's final and a women's final, followed by the playoff head-to-heads. For the men, it'll be floor, and for the women, it'll be bars. Now, the time before these competitions start, what you see here is a 2 or 3 minute warm-up, but you can be sure that these gymnasts off the area have been stretching and preparing. Girls warming up for the vault final. It's my error earlier. I said that the bars would be first, but it's the vault we'll see. That's Adrian Varga there warming up. That's Lopez there from Mexico. She pulled off a surprise just a week ago in Montreux. She took a silver medal there. Adrian Varga there, she's medalled at world and European level. Produnova, she's the perennial fourth place at the World Championships in 99, but immense vaulter. Simona Aminar, number 8, 20 years old. Really, she's an example for all gymnasts to follow. She's serene, mature, very experienced and very competitive. Denise Lopez there from Mexico. Made a world final, surprised a few people there. ...125 is the height of the girls' vault, 1.25 meters. That's 10 centimeters lower than that for the men. And looking to perform 2 vaults. Must be different. This is little Trudy McIntosh, but this isn't. This is Adrian Varga from Hungary. That's Elena Produnova. If she shows you the most difficult of her vaults, I can tell you, it's mind-blowing. Adrian Varga from Hungary, still warming up. I call performers, is the rehearsal that is so important. Many of them follow a ritual. Some like to do the complete vault, some like just to do what they call timers, preparation activities. But all have the same task, the same challenge, that is to produce perfect performance at the first time of asking. Niki Feferov. Niki Feferov. It's a difficult name, but it is. Adrian Varga. Was the name given, but I can tell you that was not Adrian Varga. We were looking there at Jana Komraskova from the Czech Republic. But we're still at these warm-up stages. A little half turn on. And a half turn out. The end. Silver medal twice he's got at world championship level. No mistaking the technique of Urzica. For the women it's the vault, and for the men the pommel horse. Adrian Varga from Hungary. Two volts. Well, she's capable of more difficulty using that bolt as a marker, I'm sure, the handspring pike front somersault. It's down on tariff, it'll be down in the 9-6 area. Handspring on, pike front, but she did tuck her legs rather early. But a good safe vault, and we await the second vault of Adrian Varga. It's two vaults. The average taken, and this is where many of these gymnasts, they come unstuck, because there you are, there's the first mark, 9.25. They come unstuck because very rarely do they train two volts sufficiently, and if you make a final they've got to be different. So 9.25 is the first, and the mark for Alexander Berish, a very healthy 9.613. Adrian Varga, second vault. It's a good vault. Use the tuck position, which is the simplest of the shapes in gymnastics to rotate in. Nice and square onto the horse. Good controlled paced run-up. Round off onto the horse. Half turn into the Arabian somersault position and lands well. That'll pick her average up a little bit. And we're looking in the background for the moment at the powerful frame of Elena Prodyunova. There she is. Stand by for fireworks if she uses the vault, controversially, because it's such a difficult vault. There was talk of banning it at one stage, or rumours of that nature anyway. But, we'll see. Will she use it, or won't she? Elena Prodyunova, third all round in the 97 World Championships. Immensely powerful on this apparatus, the vault, and also the floor exercise. You see behind her, you have to indicate the vault on the numbers board, large red numbers, and that's the vault you have to present. If you present anything different, you're in trouble.
9,112
für Elena Frodunova aus Russland. Elena Frodunova. Will she go for broke? Ah, oh, that's not the most difficult. She's cut it down, but there's a second vault to go. That was 1.5 twists. Some magic words there from the coach. And Produnova open for the 9 point. Back to Elena Produnova. Well, same vault with a different approach. She left a more difficult workout. She can handspring double front, which is immensely difficult and risky, of course. But here, using the Sukahara approach as opposed to the Ochenko, the same 1.5 twists at the end, which is extremely difficult to spot. Smiling. Clearly ahead in terms of the two performances we've seen so far. She improved 9.613, that gives her an average of 9.588. A clear leader, but still six performances to go. First of those will be from Joanna Komorskova. She was at the World Championships. She made the all-round final down in 33rd place, but in illustrious company, that's the top 36 in the world. Opens slightly out of line there, you can see. Opens with the Ochenko, so it's a round off onto the board, or a cartwheel onto the board, a backflip onto the horse, half turn look, front somersault with another half twist to complete it. Ambitious vaulting. Komorskova. She's chasing a 9.588 and she starts with a 9.3. Jana Komorskova, 9.388 she's carrying. Needs a different vault and the average of the two scores will determine her fate. Handspring, pike front, half turn. Not the same difficulty, but plenty of power all the same. The idea is to repulse upwards from the top of the horse. That's the task they have. Hands off quickly. Just excellent height. perhaps hung on to the pike a little too long to spot the landing, but that's good vaulting. Komarskova, Czech Republic. There's the verdict, 9.225 for the second vault. It wasn't as difficult as the first. 9.306 is the average. Now then, Denise Lopez pulled off a real surprise in Montreux. Took the silver medal position there. It's good to see, we said earlier, all these nations have a chance to compete in this competition. Oh, what a vault! It's not all about landings. She's quietly delighted with that, but needs to contain herself. It's not all about landings, but they do make an impression on the judges. She was great in flight as well. Good firm block, huge push off the horse, dead straight in flight in that Cuervo, and that landing, well, she couldn't ask for better. What a start for Denise Lopez. Changing the vault number. 9.613. Denise Lopez. Absolute cracker of an opening vault. But she's got to find it again. And it's got to be a different one. Little stutter in the run. Wasn't quite as impressive, but a difficult vault. She stuttered in the run, held it together onto the board, and now the relief shows. Don't we look different when they smile? The stutter in the run, just to make sure. There it is. Just to make sure of the hand placement, the round off onto the board. Half turn onto the horse, good repulsive thrust, and the half turn in the pike position. She can afford a little smile. Look at the second vault, 9.575, good enough. She's in the lead, 9.594. Well done, Denise Lopez. Andrea Raducan from Romania. They're calling her Victoria Karpenko, but I can tell you it's not her. This is Andrea Raducan from Romania. Oh, she was flat on, but converted it so well. Miraculous fast twitch reaction there. Oh, they've got it right. So we're looking at the world champion on floor. So she can jump, she's powerful, and here she is on vault. Watch how low she is, heels well over the top for rotation. She was on that horse for slightly too long. That robbed her of some height, and you can see it then affected the rotation. That's classic line. She's tiny in physique, but she has a classic line, 9.125. So, problems. Andrea, you can. Second vault. Can't make the playoffs for the 9.125. But she'll be looking to save a little face, and she does. You can see she was out of alignment. The cream strip gives you an idea of the squareness to the horse. But not the best of days for her on this apparatus. Change the approach, this time using the round off, the Yuchenko. Half turn on. There's the pike, half turn off. But not comfortable. She can vault better than that. For a first, 9338 for a second, 9231. She won't progress. Victoria Karpenko. People tipped her to win the world championship all round in China, but she was second. Super all-round gymnast. And opens with a good vault. Round off onto the horse. Straight body into the straight front Arabian, which is, it is difficult. The longer the lever, the more difficult it is to rotate. And she does it very well. Shoulders back for a good effective takeoff. There's the round off. Keeping the body straight. Forcing those heels overhead. Good vaulting. Relaxing. That's a nice one for starters. 9.5. So, very strong opening vault. Earned a 9.5. Oh, and that's such a difficult vault to bring under control. Again, using the long lever, the straight somersault or layout somersault to rotate from a handspring. And remember, that rotation has to be done within 1 meter and 25 centimeters. So it is a difficult vault. I really don't know why she chooses it, because she never gets the credit it deserves. And that landing, clearly out of control. So Victoria Karpenko, 9.5 for the first vault. Waiting for the judge's verdict. 9.388, third place, 9.444. She's been world champion, Olympic champion, and European champion as Simona Amanar on vault. She had a few problems in the last Grand Prix in Montreux, finding her form, but let's have a look. That'll do for starters. There's Octavian Belu there. What a great understanding these two, coach and performer. Yuchenko, here's the round off. Here comes the backflip. Good block. Spins once. For the double twist. This Grand Prix event. Simona Amanar opened up with a good score, 9.688. So, and a good safe vault, going to be close. Round off onto the horse, the Sukahara approach. the Arabian turn. Let's see whether the shape from here was straight or piked. Well, I think it was more piked than straight. She needs to keep it straight. So there's room for deduction there. But she had a very healthy boost. The first score. There's her second score. She's gone into first place. 9.606. She's going to be in the playoffs. And a sigh of relief. Simona Amana. We talk about power packs. Trudy McIntosh, tiny little thing, but her approach to gymnastics matches her personality. She's a real sparky, determined little character. And part of the Australian superb team performance at World Championships when they qualified in their own right for the Olympics. Oh, dear, oh dear. Handspring straight front, smacks in a twist from nowhere. So typical of her. Julie McIntosh. Speed up the top of the horse. Powerful takeoff. Look at the springboard rebounding. Smacks in the twist, loses direction a little bit, but no nonsense. That's Alana Slater, her teammate there, offering some words of advice. Opens up with a healthy 9.6. It's not over yet. Head-to-head place is still up for grabs. In the head-to-heads. Back to Trudy McIntosh. Opened up with a 9.6. Just watch the power on the runway. She lost line on the 1.5 twists, but not pleased. That's Peggy Liddick there. She did so much for Shannon Miller, the American world champion. Peggy now working with the Australians and doing a super job. Characteristic, strong plant, 1.5 twist, loses the line, struggles with the landing. .9556. Second vault pulled her down a little. She's not in the medal positions. But she'll be looking forward now to the Olympic Games. The newly inspired Australian girl. Denise Lopez. Her opportunity to improve on her silver medal position, but she achieved in the Montreux Grand Prix. Bit of a surprise it was, but she did make the vault final last year in 99, so the promise and the potential was there. Great moment for her. Oh, that stuttering run. But she converts it well. Straight curve, not the same precision in the landing when she qualified, but that's the vault she chose. They can only choose just the one attempt. She gambled everything on that. Simona Amanar. Denise Denise Lopez has given her just a slight opportunity. In flight, Lopez looked good. It was only the landing that caused her problems. Aminar needs to nail the landing absolutely. There's the Yurchenko pad in case the board is missed. There's Lopez. Her effort, very impressive indeed. Handspring, heels well over for rotation. Good lift from the horse. Straight body, rotates well in the curvo. But there's the pace. Just the one volt. She's looking at the replay. Just the one volt. Simona Aminar. Yurchenko, double twist. It looked good. It's going to be close. Slightly short on the landing, but Octavian Belu there, the coach, he thinks that his charge has got it. Let's have a closer look. Yurchenko approach. Good repulsion. That's push off the top of the horse. Makes the double twist. Loses form slightly. A little short on landing. While in the air, I think Lopez was slightly better. Not much to differ as far as the landings were concerned. Well, who's your money on? It's so close.
Winners for the Strong Weltcup, Bondi, Zuhause.
Aminar stopped. Lopez goes on, a nice little smile. And from Aminar as well, congratulating Denise Lopez. Good to see. 9.7 she got. Simona Aminar has to be satisfied with the silver medal position with 9.675. But a popular decision. Well done, Denise Lopez. Now she can smile. Well, go on then. There it is. Gold for Denise Lopez. Good discipline of shape in the air. She needs to get that one up sorted out though. Very good discipline of shape. Good push from the horse. Holds on to that shape. Rotates. The only error. So Denise Lopez takes the first of the four women's event. Here's the start list for the women's bars. Svetlana Kokina must be favorite. We've said earlier, she hasn't been beaten on this apparatus in a major competition since 1994. It's incredible, isn't it? Elena Prodyunova, her countrywoman, will challenge, and Victoria Kopenko too. That'll be a good competition. Preparation for and from Demosthenis Tambagos. Meanwhile, looking for a glimpse of Svetlana Korkina, undoubted queen of this apparatus. I'll see her at the moment. There's the start list. Li Xuan from China, good bars technique, as all the Chinese. Trojanova, she'll be challenging Kokina as well. Victoria Karpenko, excellent technique, good all-round gymnast, and bars one of her strengths as well, so this will be a good final. Laura Martinez there from Spain. She made a couple of finals of the World Championships in 99. But bars, not the strongest apparatus for her. But it's a nice mix of nations, as in all these finals. And it gives the underdog a chance to break into the limelight.
Jesus Carballo, dessen Sohn gleichen Namens Jesus Carballo, der Weltmeister am Reck ist, diesmal hier nicht dabei.
There's a lot of preparation to do, and you very often find that the team works together, coaches and gymnasts alike. The texture just right. There's a light magnesium carbonate powder for grip, usually aided by juice or sugar water, or just plain water. There's the purchase on the bar. Obviously important.
Lang ist es her. Jetzt die deutsche Turnerinnen auf Rang 15 bei den letzten Weltmeisterschaften. Nicht dabei. In Sydney zum zweiten Mal nicht als Team. Und der deutsche Turnerbund müht sich, dies zu ändern. Aber Sie wissen, liebe Gäste, die Wege im Turnen sind lang. Die Erfolgszeiten der Damen recht kurz in diesem Alter.
One final look. This is Li Wan. Discussing points of technique. He'll be first on rings, and she, like most of the Chinese team, excel on this apparatus. Lovely straight line through the pirouettes. Oh, that's nice. Invert swings. Gotcha. That's a second release. And a double layout with a super landing. New Swan from an absolute depth of talent in the Chinese camp, for men and women. Look at the body line through the pirouette. Doesn't break at the hips, sets up the invert swing. And here you can see the build-up. Into the catch-off. Good rotation. Heels well back behind her when she catches. Good technique. Powerful wind up. Pulling on that bar. Forcing the feet overhead into the dismount. Double layout. What a good landing. Well, that's the target. 9.738. The cats amongst the pigeons. The unmistakable line of Svetlana Khorkina. She finds more time, more grace, more elegance than any other female gymnast on this apparatus. Effortless. And what a way to finish. That's why she is apparently unassailable on this apparatus. Every performance oozes confidence.
Ich will gar nicht böse sein,
aber
Sie haben auch schon einen Preis vergeben mit Ihrem Beifall. Sie kriegt auf alle Fälle
Pirouette.
Den Eleganzpreis.
One and a half turns there, making up that pirouette.
Besondere Wirkung. Die
somersault between the bars, that's not easy when you're a taller gymnast. But this is impressive. There's the Stauder.
In der Geschichte dieses Geräts, so kann man das sagen. Eigentlich wollte sie aufhören, das wäre schlimm.
Clear circle. Head forced downwards to half turn and catch the bar. Plenty of height above the bar. Time to sort out that landing. She looks serious, but 9.8 should make a smile. Change of leotard for Elena Produnova, but it's the same power. This time on bars. Started well. Invert swings. Power in that catch immediately into the back, but she was short there. There was an error in the clear circle. And the dismount. Full twisting double tuck, no problem there. But there was a clear error in the performance of the routine on the lower of the two bars.
Yelena Produnova aus Rostov am Don.
Good shape control to set up the stoop Kachev. Very difficult skill. Plenty of height in the pack somersault, but watch this. She should have come out to handstand there, but you can see the problem. That was a contact circle. She had to think very quickly from there. And did well. But the judges will have seen that. Full twist in the double tuck. It's a solid dismount. But let's see what the judges make of it all. Obviously debating the error. Some may have picked it up, some may not have. And the chief judge will be instructing them on their duties there. It looks as if we have a score ready for her. Very anxious moment. You know that she'll be down. Stoop on, nice and late to keep momentum. Much of the gymnast time is spent close to the bar, as well as these longer swings away from it, and the inevitable. Long swing around the bar. See how she changes shape. There's the dismount. Full twist in the double tuck somersault. Judges obviously taking a great deal of trouble discussing how severe to be on the deduction. And there they are, they've been fairly generous, but she is capable of better than that. 9.663. She'll accept that. Tatiana Jaganova from Belarus. She entered two events and qualified for this final, missing out on the beam. So it'll all be on this. Good combination into the straddled Jaeger. Two releases so far. The big dismount. Oh, good. Did the double front somersault. Half turn into double front. Tatiana Jaganova. She qualified with a 9.65, so she's capable of a high position.
Diva des Welthochsports der 80er, Anfang der 90er Jahre. Svetlana Burginskaya, zum Beispiel.
Coach, ever vigilant on all these releases. Mustn't make contact though, because it's a deduction for the gymnast if he does so. Waiting. She can be pleased. To make the final in this company is an achievement in itself. 9.663. She's upped her performance. Tiny frame of Olga Roskupina. Now she's got acres of space between those bars and makes full use of it as well. Oh, look at that. Lovely hop above the bars with full twist. Plenty of height in the Jaeger release. Very much at home on this apparatus. Oh, yes. 16 she was just a couple of days ago. Let's see if she can get a nice belated birthday present for that performance.
Tja, Olga Roskupina, das sieht so spielerisch leicht aus, was sie da tut und was sie macht. Und diese Turnerin wird noch eine gute Figur.
The gymnast showing a variety of shapes. That's what makes up these skills. That and an awful lot of physical conditioning. She entered everything in this Grand Prix, vault, bars, beam and floor. She's made this final. And two others, beam and floor still to come. And she started well, hasn't she?
Schülerin
9.675. She has started well. No playoff for her, but that third place could bring a medal. Playoff position, so it's a repeat of the last Grand Prix. At the moment. Victoria Karpenko. Lovely work. Good precision, plenty of height, clean in the catch. She took a silver on this apparatus in the European Championships in 1998 and challenging well. And the double layout, what a lovely dismount. Absolutely nailed it. Finding the shape to complete the pirouette. Driving the feet down, letting the hips take over to set up the release. High above the bar, good clean catch. There's the pack somersault between the bars. Kokina must be watching this with some dread because being unassailable for all those years, when you see performances like this, he must feel slightly vulnerable. That's a really dream of a dismount, that. Good shape and a perfect landing. 9.775. She's close. She'll be in the playoffs. And the applause will tell you. Dagmar Ferenschild from Germany. Uprise into pirouette, straight into catch air. It's a good combination. But those little pats across the bar will cost her. Cool, good. Second release. Oh, that's a good dismount. The home crowd will be delighted with that, as is the coach, as is the gymnast. Good to see. Finds a way around the pirouetting skills. Good combination this, into the Jaeger's somersault to release. Good confident catch.
Das deutsche Frauenturnen kann nur gewinnen mit solchen Mädchen, die sich solchen Übungen stellen.
Really tugs at that bar, making sure she's got plenty of momentum. Another big tug, driving the feet down. Kicking into this dismount, which was a stormer. Full twist in the double straight. 9.65, that's a good score. Laura Martinez from Spain. Slightly fell out of that pirouette, but regained control and composure into the Jaeger. Lovely swing through. She didn't make a final on this apparatus in the World Championships, but she did so on two other apparatus. And one of those still to come, that's the beam. Coach there, Jesus Caballo, whose son is a super gymnast in his own right. But for the moment, watching his gymnast. Laura Martinez. We'll see her again on the beam final.
Tom Hase an den Ring. 10 Jahre alt. Eben war er noch ein Champion dran.
bars creep wider apart these days, it's increasingly hard for the gymnast to find ways to move between them, especially if you're slightly shorter. So more flight elements are creeping in. Lost form a little bit there. Forward swing, turns very early, a half turn in that double somersault, very difficult to bring under control. 9.6 and fifth place, Laura Martinez. Well, for the women, Lukina staved off the challenge of Kopenko for the final on A bars, or uneven bars as they're known sometimes. Oh, she likes that music. There's Kokina, you can see her in the background. There's confirmation of that playoff between the two Ks, Kokina and Kopenko. Elena Brodunova for that error dropped down to fifth. And the German interest, Dagmar Fehrenscheid, finished down. Already started her routine. Not as crisp in the handstand positions as she's accustomed to. And almost lost the dismount. You can tell he's not happy. There's Ilya Dokhaev, architect for so many years of first the Soviet system and now the Russian machine, with the men's and women's team. Not as crisp and sharp in these handstand elements and the pirouettes that she has been. But there's so much difficult work in this exercise. It's a lofty task to take victory from Kokina. That's her signature element. Those long levers of hers, she uses to very good effect. You didn't get a second look at the dismount of Kokina, but that was clearly off balance on landing, and for her, very uncharacteristic. So it's all for Victoria Kopenko, if she can hold concentration and precision. Lovely technique in the Healy. Well, going well. Just compare the two dismounts. Let's see. Well, no contest on the dismounts. Huge smile from her. She kept style, kept line. Good height in the Ginger somersault release. Again in the pack release. If it was a dismount competition alone, this young lady would take the honours. But so much depends on the structure of the routine and in the judge's view. Now Kokina must be approaching this contraption with some trepidation, because she knows that she didn't perform at her best. Whereas Karpenko was clearly determined to beat her. Let's see what the judges make of Lill. Remember, Kukina hasn't been beaten in a major competition since 1994. This is a World Cup event. And she has to concede this time. Victoria Karpenko defeats the queen of uneven bars. And look at the score, 9.825. A worthy score for a super performance. Well done, Victoria Karpenko.
Victoria Karpenko. Glückwunsch für die gleichermaßen.
She looked good enough in the first of these two final performances, but even improved on that to get into the 9.8 pluses when it really mattered.
Glückwunsch also auch von Ihnen nochmal, liebes Cottbuser Publikum, für diese Gala am Stufenplan.
Lovely body tension in that handstand shake. That's why the turn is so easy. Good shoulder condition needed for this. Again, that characteristic turn. Plenty of time, plenty of control.
Wir sehen nämlich noch eine Gruppendarbietung mit Reifen aus von Potsdam, und zwar die Kinderklasse 10 bis 12 Jahre wird sich präsentieren. Die haben es auch verdient, bitte.
Great height in the releases. Very accurate between the bars as well. Karpenko, on this occasion, had the measure of Kukina.
Gratulation nochmal an dieser Stelle. Das musste gemacht werden, weil sie war letztens nicht anwesend und Ulla Koch hat zum Beispiel das überreicht. Glückwunsch an Dagmar.
Due ceremony.
Alles Gute bei den Highlights in diesem Jahr.
Jahres wählen lässt. Und die Gewinnerin des Jahres 1999 steht hier neben mir und Sie haben sie eben bei einer Topübung am Stufenbahn gesehen und wissen jetzt, weshalb sie von den Turnjournalisten im letzten Jahr zur Turnerin des Jahres gewählt worden ist. Es ist Dagmar Fehrenschild vom TV Hoffnungsstar. Nur den Pokal, den hat sie noch nicht bekommen, weil sie nämlich Ende letzten Jahres beim internationalen Turnier in Mexiko war, wo sie ebenfalls im Backenfinale stand und dort die Bronzemedaille gewonnen hat. Deshalb überreichen wir ihr den Pokal heute, verbunden mit dem herzlichen Glückwunsch der Unterredaktion und von uns allen. Und toi toi toi, wir haben ja gesehen, du kannst es schaffen, bei den Europameisterschaften in Berlin, in Paris, Entschuldigung, dich vielleicht für die Olympischen Spiele in Sydney zu qualifizieren. Alles Gute auf deinem weiteren Weg.
Es ist nicht ein schöner, kurioser Zufall.
Performance of Dagmar Fehrenschild. Germany, meriting. Applause.
Alles Gute, Dagmar, und jenen aus Berlin und Köln, die sich auf die schweren Prüfungen dieses Jahres vorbereiten. Und noch einmal.
Our future prowess for German gymnastics, we say goodbye to you from the first day of 2 days of finals. More to come. Don't go away. Second day of finals action at Cottbus 2000 World Cup Grand Prix. Three more finals to be decided for the men and two for the women. It's good to see him back though, and good to see him motivated to carry on.
Olga Rashukina, Ukraine.
It certainly is. So she gets the second day of finals underway. Olga Rashukina on beam. Oh, she does that so well. Side somersault. Difficult. She makes it look so easy. So far, not a flicker in any of the acrobatic or gymnastic series. Another side somersault. Was that a tiny adjustment there? All those little touches. Choreography of the beam exercise, which make it interesting. Personalize the work. Oh, and that's the first error. A shoulder dip there. Still plenty of time. Into the dismount. The double tuck back. Just that loss of shoulder tension. It's going so well. But at this level, to the shoulders. Oh, that's a super vault. Double rotation from the handspring with a half twist. He's the only person to perform this in world competition. 5-1-9, and that's reachable. Xuan Liu on beam. She's taken a bronze medal at this event at World Championships. That was back in 1996. Oh, and she's off. No medal for her today. But she's been up there to medal at a World Championships. One of the trademarks of the Chinese is the height in the jumps, the confidence in the jumps. Oh, that's nice. Mixed series into handstand. Again, that lovely body line. Slightly overcooked the 360-degree turn, but big, confident attack to those leaps, but the shoulder dipped again. double tuck. You can see the step forward. She's not happy. 21 years old now and had a great career. No reason why she shouldn't carry on. Good technique in the backflip. Look at the placement of the hands and feet. Finding room. This is where the problem was. Very difficult to lay out. Left shoulder dipped, hips out of line, and there's nothing you can do. But she recovered well. I mean, look at the lift in that dismount. There's the double tuck back. But one more error to come. That's the face forward. Looking a little bit sad. Don't be. Many more. 9.075 for Xuan Li. And just... Oh, now that's uncharacteristic. Lost posture in the Aminar that we know would have won the battle to regain control, but not to be. So it's Ross Coupina who started on beam, the only one to complete without mishap. But she finished like the true gymnast and competitor she is. Such an uncharacteristic lack of tension. There's the somersault into the flick. Let's watch. Second somersault. She seems to be under control. The shoulder drops a little, but her hips are still square. Center of gravity, moves outside of the base of support, and she's off the beam. Well, she's thinking of that now and shaking her head. Why did I fall off? Gives him 9.694 as an average. Trudy McIntosh. She has a directness of style. No nonsense. She fought it and won. Combination of leaps, gymnastic series. Dear. Took about a tenth of a second to get back on the beam. Let's get on with it, she said. You see, there's a knowledgeable audience. They appreciate good gymnastics. Register with applause. Double pike back, game to the end. One wobble and one parting company episode. So she, like two others, has come to grief on this apparatus. This is what drew the audience applause. And well worth it. Impressive dismount though, the double pike. Wraps in tight, squeezes to rotate. With a 9.7 average, a 9.8 and a 9.6 there. So he's ahead of Yunfeng Zhao. And Alice Slater, slightly off balance from the front somersault. Under control. That's nice. Purpose about her work, as there is with all the Australians these days. They've really got their act together and looking forward to the Olympics. And that's a good dismount. The pace forward was forgivable. The double pike rotation. Posture, grace and elegance. Retains the posture throughout the cat leap and attacks that with such confidence. Nice lift into the double pike. Sound B2. Fresh from her victory 24 hours ago when she took gold on bars, and looking very solid on beam. It's Ross Kupina out there in front at the moment with a 9.713. Control. And the double tuck spins safely round, a little pace at the end, but that's a strong challenge from Victoria Kopenko. Came to prominence in 96 at Junior Europeans and left a lasting impression, and smoothly progressed into the senior ranks. Silver medalist last year she was. All round at the World Championships. Nine 7 1 3 is out in front at the moment. Fifth. Andrea Raducan on beam. Now it falls to her after the problems of Aminar. to represent Romania, if she possibly can, in the playoff. That's what she's going for. Oh, look at that. Nice and square in the spin. That is so impressive. Again, precision. For one so tiny, there's a classic line about her work and posture and grace. Clear. And that double pike was, as they say, a peach. Andrea Raducan, restoring pride in the Romanian camp.
Andrea Raducan hat allergrößte Chance, ganz weit oben zu stehen, denn in der Weltcupliste dieses Gerät.
Front somersault onto the beam. Very square, good firm plant of the feet. But you don't get many of these. What makes it so difficult is the twist in flight, and she's got 10 centimeters to square that landing. Here's a reward, 9.763 in the lead. Still ahead in the overall World Cup rankings for bars, but has to shoulder the defeat of the previous day here on beam. She looks tall, but it's all relative. Lovely, graceful hands and arms. A good combination. This was a difficult apparatus for her throughout last year. Caused us so many problems. Lovely. Graceful, elegant, and allows herself a quiet little smile there. Kokina has overcome that particular problem. That's the best beam performance I've seen from her for some time. Retaining posture in the bullet leap. And there's the acrobatic combination, which makes it a mixed series. That's a full twist. Or a fulva added to the corporate trick. .9775. And we can see that the two for the head-to-head, Svetlana Kokina and Andrea Raducan, what a playoff that'll be. Raducan sparkling at the World Championships on that apparatus, and Kokina having trouble who's going to emerge the victor today. Got it all to do, Svetlana Kokina. Truly was a world-class performance that you are up against. Millimeters to spare. Now look at this, she's drifting and floating through all these linking skills. That's her strength, the grace, the elegance. Not so much the difficulty. And that's what she's pitching against the agility of Radu Khan. Audience absolutely spellbound. Oh, and she really did accept the challenge. For me though, not the same difficulty. She brings something different to the beam. She brings the grace, the elegance. Radu Khan manages a balance between the two. But let's admire Kina. Longer levers. Look at the way she drifts through this skill. Full twist in the backflip onto the beam. Good 9 inches taller she is than Radu Khan, and look how close she is to the end of this beam. That is close. 20 centimeters different, at least there. And that's a turn up. Kokina allows the smile to come. More relief. But she's overcome. There was a real problem for her. The World Championships on the beam. It robbed her of the all-round, any ranking position at all there. And she seems to have won a very private battle. Look at the scores, 9.825. She takes it over the favourite, Andrea Radu Khan, 9.8. Who was very gracious in defeat. Sure. And like the men, with the horizontal bar, which follows as the last event, the women regard this as their blue ribboned event. Floor exercise, attempting to marry the essential choreography with the acrobatic and tumbling elements. Looking forward then to three more events in what's been a spectacular Grand Prix event. No question that many of these gymnasts here that have succeeded over the past 3 days in qualifying and then through final and then through to winners' playoffs, no question that these will figure in Olympic honours in a few months' time. Simone Avenar. Final word from Octavian Bellu. She tries once again to recapture some of the great form.
Stadtsportbundeskorpus Herrn Dr. Trunschke.
Unmistakable frame.
Called
that. Elena Brodunova. And that's just a little sample without the rock back, I'm sure. Lisa Bugemann from Germany will obviously get a rapturous reception from the home crowd. Waiting for something to fill. Waiting for something to judge. If that red flag goes up, you're out of the area and it'll cost you a couple of tenths. Several finals, really. Pommels rings, high bar and parallel bar, he entered. And he actually won through to three of those finals, so he's done well. Lisa Brugman. Will be the first we see on women's floor, just rehearsing the landing phase. So then, to the welcome from the home crowd, Lisa Brugman starts off this floor final for the women. And started well. Going so well. Start list, so this may be a guest appearance for a score. No doubt we'll be informed slightly later on. Lisa Brugman. Many hosting nations take the opportunity to blood some of their gymnasts in front of a crowd and with an international flavour, so this may be what's happening here. She certainly wasn't on the official start list, but all will be revealed. And that, in fact, was the case. Not an official competitor, but interesting for all that. This is Simona Amanar. She certainly is an official competitor. had to be content with silver medal. Second place on her strongest event at vault was the surprise win from Denise Lopez from Mexico. She didn't do as well as expected on the other events. And here with her last opportunity to medal. Double straight, trademark for her. Going to be critical, it's that the tumbling is always superb, but the choreography does leave a little to be desired. But that's the Romanian way on floor. Still, technically, excellent work. Detract a little from the choreography, but the tumbling certainly doesn't. In terms of the overall effect, Simona Aminar plenty of power and precision and attack in these tumbles. The length in the backflip successfully converted upwards, full twist in the double back somersault, and that's how she finished. Whip over somersault from round off. Again, the long characteristic backflip. Olga Roskutina. Score for Aminar, I can tell you now, was 9.688. Good start for her. Oh, a twist too far. Gymnastics and acrobatic moves, part of the ingredients. With Boga, good use of the music there. She had problems with the forward tumbles, looking dejected, but no reason to be. She did so well on B, fighting the tears. Lovely technique. She launches into the round off. Frames the head well with the arm action. There's the whip over somersault. Continues through into the backflip. Nicely sets up the double pike back. Alana Slater. Next to go on floor, a couple of scores for you. Began on parallel bars, got 9.55. Alana Slater. following 8.988. That was given to Roskupina for that unfortunate fall. So, Alana Slater from Australia. Good combination. Triple twist. Nice change of mood and tempo. Oh, she's presenting this well. Quite get round, but covered it well. Have a fight to finish off. Nicely choreographed and nicely presented from Alana Slater. We've said it before, she's part of a very determined, young and well-prepared Australian team. Double Pike, to bring it all to a very satisfactory conclusion for Alana. Elena Politskova from Belarus. Started well. As they all do. Good triple twist. She made the top 36 in the world at the World Championships. All round that was. That floor, one of her stronger apparatus. Very precise. Good work from Elena Politskova, Belarus. Again, though, lacking slightly in terms of the selling of the exercise, the choreography, but the tumbling was spot on. Good triple twist, this. Beg your pardon, 2.5 twists. A good combination. Spotted landings. For, Martinez from Spain. She entered 3 events and made 2 finals. Bars and here on the floor. She's had a good outing. Good twisting round, 1.5 twists through to 1.5 twist punch pike front. So complex and well performed. He does spin, doesn't he? Double twisting front she did from the handspring. And spinning again. Triple twist. That was her final tumbling gambit. All a bit frantic, but a good floor exercise and very fit and appropriate for this company. I'm sure you're getting used to this young lady's face, Victoria Kapienko. Karvinenko on Pivas, he got 9.488. Alexanderson got 9.45. So Petkovic is chasing countryman Fagan with a 9.55. We'll let you know his score as soon as it's available. Kapienko. Many are tipping her as a possible Olympic all-round champion. She certainly has the pedigree already for one so young. Silver medal at World Championships. Sure, Simon Temple had never moved quite like that. Superb start. And it goes on. So much on this final tumble, final flourish. Oh, lost control at the very end. But surely well on course for preparation for the Olympic Games. Grand Prix before the Olympics, and her build-up going very nicely. Tumbles so well, good and high in the somersaults, is a double pike. This is Sun Chaoyao, or Chaoyao Sun, as it should be. Traditionally, the Chinese girls have had problems on the floor. They don't seem to have the explosive qualities. Choreography is always reasonable, but it's the tumbling that has let them down in the past. Sun Chaoyao. Thank you. slightly low, but managed the combination there, the 2.5 twists into the front somersault. Slightly out of that pirouette, need to keep posture and control. Nothing wrong with the double pike. Sun Xiaoyao, slightly lacking in imagination, but she's marching off in the wrong direction. But she knew exactly where she was going while she was on the floor. Good lift into the double pike back. But they need to be just a little more imaginative in their choreography to match their newly found skills at tumbling. Chasing some very good scores. 9-6-8-8. Two are sharing at the moment. That's Aminar and Politskova. She's had a couple of Grand Prix recently over on, obviously, a European tour, doing the rounds of the European Grand Prix venues. She was in Montreux a week or so back. .9625 it was. So Andreas Wecker out there at the moment in a playoff position. Watch this start. Third final and third leotard. Oh, unbelievable work. Left foot go out of the area. She snatched it back. Nothing, not too much damage done there. But the power of that young lady is enormous. Nobody tumbles like she does. And the women's aspect of the sport. Look at this. Double front somersault from half turn in into another front somersault. You can forgive her that pace, can't you? Look. Handspring, double twist, into the front somersault, watch the left foot, it was out. How much damage? Elena, Remember, 9-6-8-8 is the score she's targeting. Needs to get into that playoff. And she can put right the problem with the foot. €9.75 was the score. You're not seeing it there. There's confirmation of the finalists for the women's floor for the playoff. Prozinova against Aminar and also Politkova. So there'll be three performances there in that playoff, a three-way playoff for the final of the women's events. Gymnastics, some more to come. Aminar. Finishing touches to her preparation. Three gymnasts to go. Because Politkova, Belarus, and Aminar from Romania could not be separated. But out there on her own, qualifying in spectacular style, was Elena Prodyunova. But first, it's Simona Aminar. 20 years old. She's been a world, European and Olympic champion. Plenty of experience. All of those were on the vault apparatus. She got a silver medal last year on floor and on vault. Three times she's been a world champion. Looks a little bit concerned there, doesn't she? Is Aminar. Double layout and her foot is out of the area. But it's just a 10. She can fight it back. Triple twist and again not the best of landings. Within the jumps combination. Silver she's got so far in this Grand Prix won't be pleasing to her. Final big tumble. And again, a little pace to bring it under control. Not at home with her tumbling. Not really comfortable. Still some way from her best, I feel. Two and a half twists into the punch pike front somersault. That bit was fine. She put a pace out at the start. This is Elena Politkova, who matched Aminar's score to qualify, but will be looking to surpass it in this three-way playoff. Oh, plenty of height, plenty of spring there. Good opening time. Thank you. Davis, though. She too is having slight problems. She really does stick some of those landings, and it's a feature of her work. Sell the exercise. I see more flourish. The tumbling, good. Elena Politskova doesn't look too convinced herself, does she? At this, the very highest level of tumbling ability from these girls. Look at the lift, double pike. Elena Trojanova qualified well clear with 9.75. They like to keep the scores from us in these playoffs for maximum surprise value, but I think you could probably sort out between Aminar and Politskova. I wonder if you can. It's clear for this young lady, she's got to make sure of all her landings. She can't afford any mistakes. Immensely difficult. Wonderfully energetic. Struggled to get that front somersault in, but no obvious problem with the landing. This head-to-head. No problem there. Done with such vigor, typically crisp. That's the aggression that is Trojanova. Oh, and she managed that much better. That was the improvement on her performance to get this far. Few errors for the judges. They were slightly heavy on the landings. That one was fine, the straight front into the double front. But her opening tumble, there was a pause and there was a slight heaviness about the tumble. So they've sorted out that it's between these two. Politskova considered to be the weakest of the three performances. And it's Trojanova no surprises. She was precise, daring and difficult. She managed her tumbles better than the other two. Confirmation 9.725. Perhaps the Aminar-Poliskova result could have gone either way. But Progynova, clear and undisputed as the best on show in that playoff. So the final gold medal of the women's events, the Koppers 2000 Grand Prix, goes to the Russian Elena Progynova. Simona Aminar gets her second silver medal to match the one she got on vault. But let's have another look at this. Elena Progynova, double front, the landing slightly heavy in this final, and did so well to snatch that front from it. A little low, but courageous. Delighted. Lovely smile. So from Koppers 2000, at this point, it's goodbye. More Grand Prix to come.